Hello there, very good morning to you. You're watching Proactive London and joining us today is Jo Battershill here, the Chief Executive from Anglesey Mining, because you've told the market that you're confident of a resource upgrade at your Parys Mountain. So let's maybe talk about some of these results and why you are so confident, Jo. Let's start there.
Thanks, Katie. Thanks for having me on again. Well, look, just to confirm, I mean, what we've said is we expect to see an upgrade in the confidence of the resource. If we also get an increase in the volume, then that'll be lovely to see. But I guess it's important to point out that, you know, that we only really started or restarted the activity at Parys Mountain here in November last year. So we're still very early in this process. And this first round of drilling that was completed 3 months ago, and obviously been waiting for assay results, has been very successful in helping us try to convert more of the inferred resources into the indicated, which was the key element we were trying to do here. I mean, a lot of your listeners and subscribers would be very aware that when you're going into a mine planning stage and trying to put reserves out, the reserves have to be made up of indicated and measured resources. You can't use inferred. So prior to this drilling program, we have this white rock zone at up on Parys Mountain, which is, you know, it's about 6 million tons at the moment and makes up a large portion of the feed in the first sort of 4 to 5 years of the project. Prior to this drilling program, we had 79% of it was in the indicated category and the rest was in the inferred. So what we're trying to do is use this drilling program to try and get more of that material into the indicated. So from the results we've seen, I mean, we're super confident that we've sort of hit our targets there with respect to that reclassification of that material, and the knock on from that is that, you know, it will then go into the mine plan, is the optimization, and so when we look to update the mine plan, we will hopefully be in a position where we can convert a lot of that indicated material into a mining reserve, which is when you start talking dollars and cents. So, what excites me about the White Rock Zone in particular is that it was always sort of seen as, you know, a relatively low grade, amorphous mass of mineralization, where in actual fact there's some very high grade shoots within it, and this drilling has identified and really reconfirmed for me that there's some very high grade zones that are, you know, 3, 4, 5 meters wide, that are held within a much, much broader zone of mineralization, which in places up to 60, 70 meters wide. And, you know, the rule of thumb in mining is, you know, for underground mining, is that the bigger the stopes, the lower the operating cost. So the more of that material we can bring into a mine plan, the better it is from the economics. And certainly from a metallurgical perspective, you know, there's been a lot of improvements in what we call pre-concentration techniques, and this includes dense media separation and XRT, which is X-ray transmission sorting, which a lot of people use now. And historically, there was some test work done, and it's a few years ago now for Parys Mountain, which was dense media separation, and that demonstrated that the process could remove 40%, so have a mass, what they call a mass rejection of 40% of the lower grade material to upgrade the metal or the metal grades within the component, and then goes through into the process plant. We're now in a position, now we've got the bulk of the results back, we can start cutting up some representative samples of where we're going to be mining and send it off to the lab and get that done. And I think that's going to be, it's going to be, have some very significant impacts on the mine plan. So we're very confident.
And just in conclusion, just give us the boxes that now need to be ticked in order to get you through progressing Parys Mountain through this permitting phase.
Yeah, and that's a very good question, Katie. This is a process. I've said that from day one since I joined the company last year. But, you know, I think we've got a big resource here, you know, and it's, you know, some people have always said, Parys Mountain's never quite made it because, you know, the grade's not there. Well, you know, we're demonstrating now from the drilling that the grade is there, but we've still got a process to go through, and that is, you know, we have to complete an environmental impact assessment. We're very fortunate in that we are considered to be a dormant operation as opposed to a new operation. So the permitting process is not easy, but there's a few less hurdles we need to climb over. So we, you know, but there's some still some technical elements we need to get through. And one of those is get that inferred material into the indicator, which the drilling will have done. Yeah, we've got some confirmatory metallurgical test work that we just discussed that will kick off in the next few weeks. Really, the next process on site will be commencing the design of the tailings management systems, which is critical towards permitting, and continue the ecological and environmental studies which we started back in February, March earlier this year. So, I see this is it's just a case of just going through the different stages, and hopefully at some point in the future we'll come out the back end of it with a permit and a project that's at a financial investment decision. So yeah, we're pretty confident about that.
All right, Jo, thank you very much from Anglesey Mining here on Proactive.
Pleasure. Thank you, Katie.